Hello. Alice is trying to find her way back to the beautiful garden she saw when she first arrived in Wonderland. On her way, she met the Cheshire Cat in the woods, who told Alice about the March Hare and the Hatter. Alice found the March Hare and the Hatter having a tea party.
Would you like some tea?
Tea, yes, please. And cake?
Oh, one cake.
Oh, one cake. Two cakes.
Two cakes. Oh, cakes. One lump or two of sugar.
Curiouser and curiouser.
A mountain of sugar.
They're having a tea party. But where are all the guests?
The Hatter and the March Hare were sitting at one end of a very long table, which had empty cups and plates all the way along it. But the only other guest was a mouse, who was sound asleep. Alice decided to join them.
No room here.
I'm sorry.
No room.
There's plenty of room.
Alice sat down. The Hatter opened his eyes very wide.
Why is a raven like a writing desk?
Oh, good. Riddles. I love riddles.
The March Hare looked at Alice.
You mean you know the answer, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, you should say what you mean.
I do. At least I mean what I say. Oh. That's the same thing, isn't it?
But why is a raven like a writing desk? Have you guessed the answer yet?
No, I give up. What's the answer?
I don't know. Do you know?
Oh, I don't know either.
I think you should only ask riddles if you know the answer.
Oh, have some more tea.
I haven't had any tea, have I? So I can't take more.
You mean you can't take less. It's very easy to take more than nothing.
Alice got up and walked off without saying goodbye.
Oh, more tea, Hatter.
Don't mind if I do,
come
thank
on
you.
Then, let's have a wee cup, shall we?
The Hatter and the March Hare didn't seem to notice her leaving. Alice went back into the woods. She looked back as she walked away. The Hatter and the March Hare were trying to put the mouse into the teapot.
Mousey, mousey.
In you go.
Clop.
Oh, he does wriggle, doesn't he?
That's great. Better than sugar, isn't it?
I'll never go there again. That was the stupidest tea party I've ever been to in all my life.
Back in the woods, Alice saw a tree with a door in it.
That's very curious. I wonder what could be behind a door in a tree.
In Wonderland, anything can be behind any door. Alice opened the door, and there she was at the beginning of her adventures again, in the hall with the locked doors and the table with the little key on it.
I remember that little door and the key. This time I know what to do. I'm finally going to get into the garden.
Alice had learned a lot about growing and shrinking in Wonderland. She took the key off the table first, and then ate some of the mushroom she had taken from the caterpillar and put in her pocket. Soon, she was small enough to unlock the door and go through it.
Oh, it's so pretty here.
We'll leave Alice here for now, happy in the garden at last. Soon, she's going to meet the Queen and play croquet. Will she still be happy then? I'll tell you next time.